This is my dashboard page. I can make it slightly bigger. With a couple of charts here, right? So I have some KPIs here, my revenue, my costs, my gross profits. Then I have like a monthly trend here. Then I have a breakdown, a waterfall chart, like a bridge chart of the business units. How are the business units contributing to the plan and so on? Unfortunately, here we are slightly below the plan and so on. And another table and so on, right? And what we are used to in Excel are basically, you know, just charts that, of course, will maybe react to the data. Like, of course, I can change the month here. So I can, of course, change the month and everything else will change and so on. But you would not expect, you know, the charts, that the charts would actually filter the data. All right, so this is now Zero BI 2.0 with the filtering option in Excel. So now what I can do is I can click directly on a chart here. So just click on July and I'll get the results for July in all the other Zero BI charts that are on this worksheet. Okay, right? Also, I could now, I could say, all right, I want gross profit instead of revenue. Okay, it's revenue. Maybe I'm looking at costs. Now see what's going on with the costs. Why is it red here and so on? Gross profit and so on, right? So as you see now, every Zebra BI visual that is on the worksheet is actually filtering other visuals. Okay, so how do you achieve that? How does this work in this magical way? By the way, you can also cross filter. So for example, now I can say something like this. Oh, I want results for September. And then, for September, like this. And if you press shift click or control click, right? You add the data points to the filter selection. So you can basically select multiple charts, multiple data points here. So this would be, this could be like the third quarter here, right? And you just click on those selections and it will work across the whole dashboard. Okay, so this is basically the experience that you are used to having in Power BI, right? So this is how Power BI works. And now we are bringing basically the exact same functionality of Power BI into Excel, okay? And now this works with the pivot tables. And how come that Zebra BI actually works like that? Okay, let me try to recreate this. Okay, so this table, this visual here was created from this little pivot table here. So basically I have my three main KPIs, revenue, cost and gross profit, and I have my actuals compared to my plan, okay, for those three KPIs. So I'll insert my Zebra BI tables for office. Okay, so this is now my visual. I'll just move it onto the dashboard. Okay. And how do you make it filter other visuals? Just click. So it actually works automatically out of the box. Okay, because this visual was created from this pivot table. And the other thing is this pivot table has this slicer that was created from the pivot table. So I actually created this slicer in advance from this pivot table. And at the point where I inserted the Zebra BI chart, the Zebra BI table, from this pivot table, Zebra BI actually checked if there are any slicers connected to this pivot table, and it is now actually connected to this slicer. So when I, so if I move the slicer here, just for you to understand. So when I basically, when I click on, when I select a data point here, basically the Zebra BI visual is controlling this slicer. And now, of course, this slicer is then controlling through the pivot tables, the other pivot tables that then change all the other charts. So basically, which means that basically Zebra BI visuals are now not just, you know, it's not just output, it's not just charting and drawing things, but it's also controlling pivot tables and slicers at the same time. And this is how you simply achieve. So now you can remove all of those slicers from your Excel dashboards, you know, just hide them somewhere and simply allow users to click directly on the chart, because this experience, I believe, is you know, actually much, much better than clicking on slicers, right? Just click directly. And yeah, this is now, so now this monthly chart is now actually changing through the slicer, my pivot table that is also here. So when I click June, voila, now I have June here. Okay, so this is what we call cross visual filtering in Excel. This is, I guess, the first, these are the first and only visuals in the market that can actually do that. If you insert like a native chart, native Excel chart, you know, of course you can't do this, you know. Of course you can click here, but you'll just select some data points, right? Nothing will happen. Whereas Zebra BI now have this capability of filtering other objects.